Including me. grocery store the other day in the cracker aisle, and a woman there told me that she always buys a certain cracker, and I was there kind of pondering which ones I wanted, and they were on sale, they were a good price, and so she really gave a good pitch on these crackers that she always has, crackers I've never tried before. I usually go with premium soda crackers. So I did do what she said, I bought those ones, and you know what? She was right. They were really good crackers. So she was a credible source. She had tried the crackers, so she knew what she was kind of talking about. So the results of taking some credible advice is good. In 1 Kings chapter 22, we read the story of the king of Israel and the prophet Micaiah. So to give you a little bit of background, King Ahab precedes King Omri, his dad. King Omri was an evil king who reigned for 12 years, and his son King Ahab ruled for 22 years. King Ahab is married to Jezebel. You know, you're familiar with Jezebel? She wasn't very good, was she? And together they worship Baal, B-A-A-L. So from gotquestions.org, I have the definition of Baal. Baal was the name of a supreme god, little g, worshipped in ancient Canaan or Phoenicia. The practice of Baal worship infiltrated Jewish religious life during the time of Judges, and it became widespread in Israel during the reign of King Ahab, and also affected Judah. The word Baal comes from Lord with a little l, and the plural is Baalim. In general, Baal was a fertility god, little g, who was believed to enable the earth to produce crops and people to produce children. The Bible says King Ahab provoked the Lord more than all the kings before him, meaning he was stubborn, he was selfish, disobedient, evil. He was the worst character than all the kings before him. So King Ahab asked Jehoshaphat if he was willing to go to war with him to reclaim Ramoth-Gilead. But before Jehoshaphat says yes, he asked King Ahab to ask the Lord through the prophets whether they would be successful and win or not. Now, King Ahab had over 400 prophets who followed Baal. So that is 400 opinions, and they all said, yes, you will go, you will win. Our Lord, little Al, says so. But despite their answer, despite the fact that they all agreed together that it was all right for them to go, Jehoshaphat hesitated. That was his buddy. He hesitated and wanted a second opinion. So he asked King Ahab if there was another prophet that they could ask, a prophet of the Lord, Big L. Yahweh, another name, as we learned in Bible study, for Jehovah God. And King Ahab answered and said, there is one, Micaiah, but I hate him because he never tells me anything good. I hate him. He does not tell me what I want to hear. Listen to the 400, the ones that tickle your ears and tell you what you want to hear. But don't bother with Micaiah. I hate him. He does not tell me what I want to hear. And Jehoshaphat answers, don't say that about the Lord's prophet. So they send for Micaiah, and the messenger that goes to get him tells Micaiah. So the messenger goes and says, you have to say what all the other prophets are saying. You're the only one prophet, and there are 400, so say that the king will win the battle, okay? So Micaiah answered and says, he will only say what the Lord tells him to say. In other words, he did not care what the others were saying. I'm taking my orders from the Lord Almighty, from Yahweh, from God Almighty, Jehovah God. So when he was brought before the king, and the question is asked, and Micaiah sarcastically now tells the king that he will win the battle. But the answer does not set right with King Ahab, who tells Micaiah to tell him the truth as the Lord told him. Turn to your neighbor and say, the truth can hurt sometimes.
tell it anyway.
So Micaiah tells him that they will not only lose the battle, but that the Lord has set it up so that the 400 prophets of Baal has lied to them, and they will believe their lies. So King Ahab asked for the truth, but he did not like the answer. He even said to Jehoshaphat, "See, I told you, Micaiah would not say nothing good, have anything good to say. He never has anything good to say." But do you listen to Micaiah? Do they listen to him? You think they listen to him? No. They follow the 400 prophets of Baal. They follow the crowd, the majority, the ones that told them that what they wanted to hear. Not only that, they put Micaiah in jail because they did not like what he had to say. So when we don't like or we don't want to hear the truth, do we shut it out or shut it down just like King Ahab did? This message is for someone here today. What happens when we stop listening to the advice from a credible source? What happens when we close our ears to the one, the closest one to us, that would mean us no harm? Someone knows what I'm talking about here. Who do we ask for advice? Do we go to the one who will tickle our ears, tell us what we want to hear? The truth can set you free. Even if you stand alone and no one stands with you, can I get an amen?
Amen.
Biblical truth will set you free. It already has. In this particular Bible story, the results of following the wrong crowd, wrong advice, popular poll, led to them losing the battle, not only losing the battle, also to King Ahab's horrible death. Read the entire chapter for yourself. In the responsive reading this morning, we read Jesus' words, how he is the gatekeeper or good shepherd, my shepherd, your shepherd, who goes ahead, and that his sheep, those who know and believe in Jesus, follow him because they know his voice. In verse 5 it says, his sheep will not follow a stranger because they do not recognize a stranger's voice. Do we recognize Jesus' voice? In 2016, let's make prayer a priority. And then listen to the advice that the Holy Spirit sends our way. God has provided us, church, with a spirit-filled prophet, Pastor Laquita Porter, who will not steer us wrong. We need to thank God for her vision to build up God's people for his good purpose.
Amen.
So, good, credible advice could come in a number of ways. It could come through a sermon, Bible study, and or private devotion, to name a few. This is how we become stronger, church. Stronger in our faith. Last week, Deacon Allen spoke how people should know that you are a Christian from your lifestyle, which is based on the Word. You see, if you follow Jesus and the examples he gave, you are following Jehovah God, God the Father. By following the Ten Commandments, you are obedient to God. You're putting God first. Also, loving your neighbors as yourself. In John 8:12, it reads, again, Jesus spoke to them saying, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. A beautiful truth. Following the word of God is good advice. John 8:32 reads, and you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. I love the words of that hymn, I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. The world behind me, the cross before me. Look to Jesus, who paid it all for your life and for mine. He rose to die no more and sits at the right hand of the Father, making our request known. There may be someone here today who has been following the wrong advice, or a crowd of false prophets, or perhaps one false prophet who has been steering you wrong, away from Jesus. You will not go wrong with Jesus as your leader. Yes, you will have bumpy places. also be smooth places along the way. And it's all worth it. All worth it in the end. 'Tis so sweet to trust in Jesus, just to take him at his word. To have that peace in your soul in knowing that he made the best, you made the best choice ever. Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. Make Jesus your choice today, 2016 and beyond. Walk by faith and not by sight. Deacon, you can start that now. So won't you join the crowd of Christian believers who follow Jesus? Jesus died on the cross for you and I, and he bids you to come. Come to Jesus. I'm so glad that I made Jesus my choice. Come by faith and not by sight. Make Jesus your choice today. As this song plays, there may be those here today that would like to come forward publicly right now. As these deacons walk the aisle, it is your time. Come on. Make Jesus your choice in 2016 and beyond.